Tower.
This artifact was a gift from Gondor's other frontier, the long beaches of Unfalas along Gondor's distant shores. Their lord, Galazgil, sent us this ceremonial bowl with water from the river Morthond, and we kept the bowl long after the water had evaporated. I've often daydreamed of visiting Unfalas. I think I'd like it better than the capital city of Minas Tirith. There is too much of the frontier within me to be happy living in settled lands.
This bowl is far from home.
As are we all, Celebrimbor.
Tremble before me!
Balrog will devour Middle-earth if we do not stop it.
No small task, but with Carnan we have a chance.
Finding the Balrog shouldn't be difficult.
Indeed. It is what comes after.
Tar Goroth fouls earth and sky. Plows a path of flame. Haste, haste, haste! It rages across land, scorches a path.
Tar Goroth will not be difficult to find.
Escape this Tar Goroth. Freeze Mordor to burn your lands. To the depths. Fang and claw will cure you, Orkling. It burns all. Mordor does not belong to you!
From another world. It is up to us now, Talion. This isn't working!
Oh. must attack. Send this beast to the depths. Send this beast to the depths.
Thank you.
us fall upon it.
Most Gondorians, this midnight urn is a simple pot of clay, but to the denizens of Minas Ithil, it represented shared sacrifice that only those who live on the frontier understand. For centuries, the name of every able-bodied resident of Minas Ithil was placed in the midnight urn, and at sunset, a name was drawn. That person would have to patrol the city's walls until sunrise. The task was ceremonial once we had a professional army. But that made it no less important. From our earliest days, it was always a neighbor watching from the walls. I was 10 the first time they drew my name, and I've never been prouder, though I could barely see over the parapet.
Gonna bury you!
Why leave the defense of your walls to chance?
It isn't about chance. It's about unity. Everyone's names are mixed together. And everyone takes a turn on the wall.